Welcome again to Advancing AI 2025. I'm actually here, and this is a very special and honored to be here with two friends of mine, Alex Mashrabov from Higgsfield AI and Jeff Tatarchuk from TensorWave. And we're here today to talk about a very unique thing that we partnered on over the last number of months, a Hyperreal AI-generated film called Void Run. Featuring a character called M, a female developer, very brave and curious and courageous, who finds something that she wants to go and bring to developers, and the story develops out there. This is a concept that we put together, and we approached, first of all, we approached Alex in Higgsfield, and maybe Alex, I'll turn to you first, and let's talk about what it takes to create an AI-generated film, if you will.
Totally. The interesting part is that all the stages of pre-production, production, and post-production process actually remain the same.
Sure.
The only difference is that instead of the using traditional 3D rendering engines, we do leverage the GPUs, the AMD GPUs. Mm-hmm. Those GPUs are used at each stage of the process. Mm-hmm. So it can be used to help to write a script, to co-define the visual appearance of the characters, and then to actually generate the pixels, which get then post-produced. There is definitely human revision and human touch at each stage of the process, ensuring that the quality remains to be high.
So it's a tool for creativity.
Definitely. And the most interesting part is that it doesn't really change the pipeline. Mm-hmm. So it's a set of tools for each of the participants of the creative process, but not the replacements.
Yeah, and maybe we should show the audience maybe a clip of this.
Totally.
I used to think I was good at tuning things out. Everyone typing the same thing in the same way. But that night, I saw something.
So Jeff,
yeah.
First of all, congratulations on TensorWave's Series A investment, $100 million. That's fantastic for the company.
Well, thanks to AMD for participating.
You've been an integral partner to us as we've built out our Instinct portfolio, and always very vocal in support of the open approach. Building a film like this, because that's what it is, you're building it, requires quite a significant investment, if you will, from an infrastructure perspective. Maybe can you tell the audience, first of all, what TensorWave do, but also about how you helped bring us there, help create this film and bring it to life?
Yeah, well, we're an AMD GPU cloud. We provide bare metal services for AI companies. And I met Alex a few months back, and he came to me and said, I need compute. And the current SKU of GPUs that were available didn't have enough memory for them to run the workloads that needed to run for their Gen AI workloads. And we were working initially with the MI300s, mm-hmm. that had the 192 gigabytes of VRAM. And then we were able to do the most recent 325s with the 256 gigabytes of VRAM, and even faster memory. And so we've been able to do a lot more, a lot faster, because of the AMD GPUs, which we're seeing now, especially on the inference side, memory makes all the difference. They're
totally
very heavy memory workloads, and it's been amazing.
And I think as well, this is the first example, if you will, of a rendered film on MI325. So it's been amazing to be able to partner with you to bring this to life. Alex, I'm going to turn back to you again. You mentioned something earlier on that I think is really important around AI being, this tool that you have being an augmentation tool. But also requires a lot of creativity as well. Can we talk through maybe the creative process in how we build these films and the type of input you need from the creative side of your business, not just the IT and the AI side of your business?
Totally. I think a lot of the visual models, mm-hmm. come with their own biases.
Okay.
In the same way as artists come with their own preferences, their own style, and own biases as well. So I remember when one of the conversations, we definitely wanted to follow the initial script and train a model in a way that it preserves one character, but it has a very specific type of the haircut. And I remember that it was a very, it was very, very challenging, as it appears that the model was very, very resistant to those, to those archetype of the character. So just being able to fine-tune the model, to do the post-training, I think what specializes, where what we specialize in at Higgsfield, and we are happy that we made Void Run live today.
And you know, just on that as well, Alex, you know, the character herself, M, you know, we spent a lot of time, you know, researching and building that character. How easy or how difficult is it to maintain, you know, the credibility of that character all the way through?
Totally. So that's where we need. That's where we needed to train a custom model, mm-hmm. specifically for character consistency throughout the video. I think one of the interesting aspects of that is it requires a very thoughtful character design, mm-hmm. which is somewhat similar to gaming process.
So I think we have to look at another clip of this film and see this character in more detail.
I knew I had one job. Get Rock'em out. Get it open.
Jeff, today at Advancing AI, we sat through some amazing announcements, but we heard the word open a lot and the role of the open ecosystem. And I know that TensorWave are an integral part of that open ecosystem. In your opinion, what's the role of the open ecosystem, especially when it comes to creativity and when it comes to these use cases that are emerging using AI?
Yeah, well, that's one of the things that TensorWave is aligned with on AMD in supporting the open ecosystem. Supporting all the open communities that are out there to provide them with the resources to continue to keep the cutting edge, to move things forward. And so we saw with a lot of the inference stacks, they're now currently outperforming the proprietary inference stacks. And that's just a true testament to what supporting the open ecosystem can continue to do, which we're excited to continue to empower that in the developer community and beyond.
So it becomes this sort of open community working together to really accelerate innovation in an open manner. And you know, my favorite part of this film was the ending. And we're going to look at the ending now.
Now, with Rock'em, we're free to dream, to build, to learn, to explore, to open possibility. And we're just getting started.
What I loved about that was it was around open possibilities. And I think what we've seen in this collaboration as well is that when you bring partners together, the art of the possible is always there. And to build something like this is fantastic. Let's go back to AI itself as a technology. Alex, you've seen how your company has been born as this startup, if you will, and, you know, embracing the creativity side of model development. What are the next steps for you and your company on your journey?
I think that media generative AI, and particularly video generative AI, likely 3-5 years behind the LLM development. And we are very early in terms of the adoption of video AI. So there is definitely a very active community of AI prompt engineers, maybe 20, 30,000 people throughout the world who pay for various tools. But at the same time, when we think about social media creative professionals, we talk about tens of millions of paying users. And there are some companies who capitalize on this user base in the space of graphic design. And we do believe that there is a lot of work which needs to be done to reduce the level of hallucination and also to make it accessible for a wider range of creative professionals.
And I think it's also important that AI creativity in itself should be known as AI creativity and shouldn't replace something or, you know, have more, you know, deep fakes or biases in that way. So that's really good to know. Jeff, I'm going to turn back to you, because I know you're one of our you know, closest partners, especially in our Instinct GPU portfolio and into the MI350 series and beyond, hopefully, as well. What are the next steps for TensorWave?
For us, it's to continue to build the platform and ecosystem that can support and scale the Higgsfields of the world. Like you mentioned, going from 20,000 to tens of millions of users takes a lot of GPUs, takes a lot of power, takes a lot of infrastructure to support that, and we're excited about building that out and making it as easy to use so that they can do all of the creative stuff, and we make it work on the back end.
Make it just easier in the back end.
That's right.
Well, gentlemen, it's been a pleasure to have you both here, and I really appreciate the time that you took to come over and chat to us, and I hope our audience appreciates the film as well, and you know, maybe this could be the start of a beautiful relationship.
I love it.
Great stuff. Thank you,
Alex.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you.